This week on Maker Update, an umbrella you don't have to hold, Go-Go Gadget dunk legs, an extremely tiny LED circuit, and the best threads for your 3D prints. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we keep you up to date on all the cool things that makers are making. I'm Tyler Weingartner, and I hope you're all enjoying the new year. We've got a fantastic show for you, so let's get started with the project of the week. No one likes getting caught in a rainstorm. Fortunately, humans came up with a pretty effective solution to this around 4,000 years ago, the umbrella. But as it is, the umbrella hasn't changed much in that time. Materials have gotten better, lighter, and stronger, and they've gotten cheaper overall. But you still need to have one of your hands tied up to use it, at least until this week. iBuildStuff has solved this one annoying problem by making a flying umbrella. His flying umbrella is essentially a quadcopter with a really large wingspan and a hole through the middle to secure the umbrella shaft. Simple enough, right? Okay, probably not. Since the umbrella membrane blocks water, it also blocks wind, so the propellers need to extend beyond the edges or else they're not going to work. Fortunately for him, DIY drones are a pretty well-solved and well-documented problem. But that doesn't mean it was easy. Some short circuit he created along the way damaged a bunch of electronics when he first connected them to power, which gave him the opportunity to rework the design while waiting for replacement parts. He made use of thinner, lighter wires to reduce the weight, as well as breakaway terminals to allow for easy disassembly. When the day finally came for a proper test flight, you could sense his palpable nervousness. Most projects, you get to sneak up on them, and the final working version almost seems like a non-event when you realize you've swatted the last bug. But most projects don't literally take flight. The first few flights were a little rocky, but after some tuning, things got a lot more stable. You still need to manually control it instead of having it automatically follow you, but it's a fun idea, a great video, and some solid design. More projects. If you love ridiculous engineering concepts, check out these high dunk pneumatic legs by Shane from Stuff Made Here. Like with so many of his videos, he begins with a ridiculous concept and what sounds like a simple solution. He wants to be able to dunk a basketball, so he needs longer legs. Pneumatics are a great way to extend a pair of telescoping tubes, but making them strong enough to lift the weight of a person is incredibly dangerous, since they're basically a pair of really powerful springs. Most of the engineering you see here is mitigating that danger. He needs to keep the tubes sealed so they don't leak air or have an explosive decompression. Whoa. And he needs to help guide them with a rail and control the extension with an auto belay system to keep them from extending violently once his weight is off of them. There's a scissor lift style system to restrict their extension, and initially, a vertical track to guide their movement, though he eventually learns to use them without these. Next up, we have this LED industrial piercing by Mitzella. This is a small stainless steel rod that passes through two points of the wearer's ear. They're cool looking enough on their own, but what doesn't look better with the addition of LEDs? This is circuit design on a crazy tiny scale. He's making use of a hypodermic needle for the outer shaft of the piercing, and it's just 1.6 millimeters in diameter. For the circuit, he's made a flexible PCB that's just 1 millimeter wide. I think my favorite part is where he shows some 1 millimeter pitch header pins in contrast to the traditional 0.1 inch header pins. And the smaller pins still look giant compared to the rest of the circuit. This project has a ton of incredible and intricate design considerations, but there's no denying it. It looks amazing. And finally, we have this 3D printed miniature Yule log fireplace created by the Ruiz brothers. This is a simple enough project with a microcontroller and a TFT display, but the real conversation piece is the board. The Adafruit Qualia ESP32 S3. This is an Adafruit microcontroller designed specifically to drive higher resolution displays than what is typically possible for SPI interfaces. Here it's used to create the festive flames, but like they show in the video, there's plenty more you can put in here. This looks like some really fun hardware to play with. Speaking of cool tools to play with, Thomas Sandlatterer has a great video about heat press threaded inserts for 3D printing. He's interested in finding out which ones are the best, and if they're really better than just 3D printed threads. By using a torque sensor, he put them all to the torture test using a custom jig. The surprise was that the threaded inserts intended for injection molding tended to outperform the inserts custom made for 3D printing. But don't just read the headlines here. There's a ton of useful info throughout this entire video. Adam Savage has some great tips on how to start setting up the terrifying blank canvas of a new shop. The TLDR here is that once you have it set up for your infrastructure, with your power, air, etc., let it be a bit amorphous and don't overplan it. Put things where you think they should go, but don't get too mired in the idea if that's where they'll always be. Be flexible, move things around where they need to be, and just go with what seems to make the most sense. Devin from Make Anything has a video about 3D printing auxetic art. Auxetic objects express a property where, when stretching in one direction, they also extend in a perpendicular direction. Each tile also rotates 90 degrees as it's reshaping, which allows for the creation of dynamic patterns in the overall shape. This seems like a fun design concept to play around with different shapes, tile patterns, or however else the creativity grabs you. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we're checking out Becky Stern's video about her favorite tools and boards from 2023. There's a smattering of boards and other electronic goodies like the Arduino R4 Wi-Fi and some nifty computer vision boards from Seed and DF Robot. But don't miss out on her other shop recommendations, like these pump top dispensers for shop chemicals, or this multi-bit precision screwdriver. Tons of great stuff here. All right, and that is gonna do it for this week's show. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you've had a great time with it. If you did, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, and hit subscribe with the bell to make sure you don't miss the next one. As always, great big thanks to DigiKey for making this whole show possible and to you for watching. Take care, we'll see you soon.